Hey guys, welcome back to the Truth Room. It has been a while since I've done a video. Lots has been going on, really exciting changes. And I want to dedicate this video to self-trust. Check it out. I work with many people that have a core issue around self-trust and may not even know that that's what's really going on. I personally had a very interesting battle with self-trust myself, where what happens when we are taught or believe that we can't trust our natural inner guidance is we start to almost have this internal battle with ourselves. We start to question what we truly want, and we start to do the opposite. And we start to believe that these created ideals of what we want or what we should have in order to stay safe within our system, family, society, what have you, is what we need to adopt. And in doing that, we reject or bury or deny some really deep messages from our soul. When we do that, in essence, what we're doing is we're trading in our internal guidance for an external set of rules. We're trading in this, what I call, wise guide inside for an external sort of structure that's been laid out by people, not by God or the universe. When we do that, we're always seeking. We're always looking for opinions. We're always looking for approval. We're always looking for external safety and security. But here's the amazing thing, and so much of my life was about, let's just say my entire journey was about really engaging with this higher source, this higher perspective that I found within myself, and which is what I teach others to find within themselves in Soul Lab. And really what that is an internal system that we're all born with. And when we really connect to that internal system, which takes a few interesting steps, which I'll describe, but when we connect with that system, there's never any doubt. There's never again any question. And instead, there's a lot of healing that goes on for realizing why you ever had to adopt anyone else's rules or laws in the first place. Many of us are born these days to be system busters. We're born with very strong senses of who we are, very strong will, very strong knowing of what we like, what we don't like, specific. We're very sensitive and can feel other people and things. We have this internal mechanism that knows it wants to be heard. And in a way, we bust those old systems because we can't ever fully deny that voice. Many people deny that voice because they simply don't have as much of a need to change the system. But those of us who are system busters, and you know who you are, have an internal fight and battle, and I want to talk about that. This warrior-like nature that many of us have coming into this life is really about being the change. It's really about turning inward and then helping others turn inward to really see that your guidance, your soul's purpose, your highest potential is reached when you listen to these inner set of rules, not this outer set of standards. The standards were put in place because there's a system in this world to make the world work. But the new age is really about, or the new paradigm is really about self-fulfillment, self-potential, realizing true self, realizing the creator within, realizing that this world can actually be more of a heaven on earth. So the things that we have to go through to reestablish our self-trust so that we can continue this beautiful purpose that we are instilled with at birth is really not battling our conditioning, but understanding it from a higher perspective, understanding what happened to you, understanding how you ever stopped trusting yourself in the first place or never learned how to trust yourself, really forgiving others and yourselves for buying into this old system, really letting go of the need for opinions and approval and finding your own opinions and approval aligned with something higher, not your ego-based, but your truth-based opinions and approval. And that happens really by healing these wounds of not having self-trust, healing these wounds from your conditioning. We're going to go into that now. The goal is to be happy and to be free. So many of us at times in life don't feel free or happy because A, we're dependent on opinions and approval. We are also dependent on our conditions to be happy and to feel free. We're dependent on external security to feel happy and free. And the truth is, the opposite is waiting for you. Of course, I was stuck in that cycle as well, and that's how I learned through it, that that's not where it's at. There was something higher always calling to me, and what I finally did, which I'm encouraging everyone to do, is I finally had the courage to do it differently. I finally had the courage to say, this is not working for me. Your way is not working for me. What is my way? And by going deep within and asking questions, what makes me feel good? What makes me feel scared? Why does this make me feel scared? I want to be free of everything that makes me feel scared. I want to be free of everything that makes me feel unsafe. And daring to go in those places is what creates the awareness and the higher expanded vision. I took each thing that would make me have pause and that would make me do something different than myself, than what I really wanted to do, make me act out, make me whatever, and I would go into it and say, but why? Why am I so afraid of this thing that then repels me from who I truly am? And I would stay in the fire for as long as it took until I got my answer. And my answer every single time was a deep misinterpretation about myself, about life, about others. And when I would stay within myself, never abandoning yourself when you're in the face of fear, stay with yourself, no matter what that means about you. Stay with yourself, no matter how unworthy that might mean you are in your head. Stay with yourself, no matter how uncool or how unchosen or how unloved that means you are. Stay with yourself. When you stay with yourself, you come out the other end with yourself. And that is freedom, and that is happiness. And when you can totally be who you truly are in the face of everything you think may reject you, may not love you, may prove your unworthiness, that's when you start to heal, because you see that it was never anything other than fear. It was never anything other than a condition that was placed on you by someone else, by something, by some idea. And you get to upgrade your own ideas about your own life, about yourself, about who you are, about how life really works. When you bust out of this system-based thinking, you awaken to this internal wisdom that really has never left you. It's always been there, just been waiting for you, just been waiting for you to say, I choose you. I'm not buying into this stuff anymore. And every time you choose you, every time you stay in the fire and you learn through the experience of it, every time gains more and more self-trust. And eventually what happens is you start thinking, why would I ever question that in the first place? It takes time. It takes effort. I've laid out the entire process for you in Soul Lab, so I hope you check that out. It'll be below in the comments, the links and things like that. But I'm also going to be doing more videos about self-trust, because it is the core to all other issues. Once we master self-trust and we start having a relationship with ourselves in a trusting way, everything shifts. Have a good week.